Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from my kitchen. And now, 4 o'clock, dinner preparation time. I've got the chicken marinating in the refrigerator. It's going on the grill later. I decided I need a coleslaw type salad and a pasta type salad. I decided against ramen noodles, wasn't in the mood. I don't think we have enough light. I felt like I'm gemelli pasta today. I love gemelli pasta. It's not as whirly as your conventional regular, what are they called? They're not fusillis. Fusillis are something different, but they call them fusillis, I think. The corkscrew stuff. This is nice little twists. I like twists. And as usual, I've made too much pasta, because I forget that in the bowl there's also going to be a bunch of veggies, but oh well. So I decided, since I'm running low on time and energy and still have loads to do, I'm going to make two salads at the same time. Chop the vegetables, throw in that bowl. Chop the vegetables, throw it in that bowl, and so on and so forth. This one is going to be vinaigrette-based, the coleslaw this time, because last time, remember, I made it for Memorial Day, I think I made it with curry, or curry and mayonnaise. So this one's going to be the vinaigrette-based one this time. This one's going to be the mayonnaise-based one this time. It's going to be gemellis and green peppers and cucumber, maybe some black olive, because my winemaker Jim likes black olives a lot. And then I think I'm going to make it with Cajun seasoning and mayonnaise. I will be back and show you that part and make a whole compilation of this meal in little snippets of the whole meal. That's what I'll do. See you in a bit. Okay, I'm back, and here's dueling salads. I've chopped all the vegetables with my trusty paring knife that everyone comments on. That's where my knife skills lie, people. Paring knife. It's fast. Look at how beautiful the julienne is on my carrots. And here, so there I have my red cabbage and carrots. That's all that's going to be. And I'm going to put in some of that beautiful horseradish that I bought. And in this one, I'm going to have the gemelli pasta. And I've got cubed cucumbers, diced up small bell pepper. I decided against black olives because we have them all the time and I don't feel like it. And in there I have a half a can of diced tomatoes with green chilies because this is going to be the Cajun one. It's like Rotel. It's very spicy. So I'm going to put the pasta in there and then I'm going to use this I found in Mom's cupboard. A brand new thing of McCormick Cajun seasoning underneath which it says great for chicken. I'm not using it on chicken. I'm using it in my salad and it tastes a lot like Old Bay seasoning. There's something in there. I read the label. It says ingredients, spices. So we'll never know what the secret ingredient is that I can't figure out what it is because it's not on the label. Okay, I'm going to whack those two salads together. That one's already got some vinegar in it. It's going to get some olive oil and horseradish and whatever I decide to put in there. That's going to get what you saw, and I will be back for the chicken portion of the video. The party is well underway. We have our blue drinks, we have our scotch drinks, we have jalapeno cheddar dip and scoops, and then I took all my cheese ends and I put them in a little bowl and I microwaved them. I had all these ends of cheese. There was Swiss and brie and cheddar, and I put it in a bowl and I microwaved it for 30 seconds until it bubbled and all the butterfat separated, and then I served it with a spoon and crackers. It would have been delicious on French bread. There's Agnes. She feels like she needs some cheese. She smells everybody else's cheese and she thinks that she gets cheese because we get cheese. I haven't given her any yet. Over here, corn. I forgot to show you. I've made colorful salads, as you know, and we're also going to have corn with it. I'm about to pull out the grill and get it fired up and heating, then I'll be back for the chicken part. Delicious mountain of drumsticks, delicious marinated breasts, and those are marinated too. Yum. Headed for the grill. Be right back. Okay, you've missed all the cooking parts. It doesn't matter. It's been quite a lot of cooking. There we have the delicious drumsticks teriyaki and the breasts teriyaki. Yes, the sweet sauce made it burn on the outside. Yes, you're all going to give me better barbecuing tips. Great. It's still going to taste delicious, even though it's a little black right now. Then, corn. Delicious, yummy, butter and sugar corn all around. Except mine's still in the microwave. Delicious pasta salad. You saw that earlier. Delicious red cabbage salad. You saw that earlier. Some delicious Szechuan dipping sauce mixed with vinegar for a little bit of zing and tartness. Delicious homemade wine made by this gentleman here. What is it?
Pinot Grigio.
We have Pinot Grigio here today on the House of Snarzel deck. Yum yum. See you tomorrow for breakfast. Thank you for watching. I'm making them see what they're having for dessert by watching my video. They can't have dessert without watching the video about how I made it. Be right back. Okay, while they're watching my video, I've stealthed into the kitchen to grab the delicious Tostito cups from yesterday. Mom's friends will have two or three apiece. Mom will have one. They're still in there watching the video. Think about that, people. Think about it as a presentation style. You show your friends a video of you making their dinner while you're making it. Interesting, right? Be right back. Okay, there they are. I've threatened them all not to speak or eat until I take the final shot. All right, you guys, take a bite. Tell the peeps what you think.
Super.
Yum. Very yum. It's really good.
Okay, you heard it here first at the House of Snarzel Saturday night dinner party. See you for breakfast. Yum, yum, yum. Thanks for watching.